I'd like to speak the top-down parsing. You missed one. That is the brute force parsing technique. That's the leftmost. Then comes the recursive descent. The recursive descent doesn't allow the any left recursion. Okay, only. But that. But the, what is the difference between brute force? Brute force can take all parsing, but it get O n cube or O n to the power 4. N is a number of terminals, and it has a space complexity also. Lots of space it takes. And then comes the recursive descent. Recursive descent, the rules has to be modified that there will be no left recursion. Okay, right recursion can be no issue for the recursive descent. Yeah. But recursive descent can also backtrack. It can also backtrack. It doesn't avoid backtrack, and backtrack means the time complexity, space complexity more. The next best solution is the LL1 parsing. What is the LL1 parsing? No left recursion. No left recursion should be there. Then you have to calculate. Then you have to take the variables, and you have to calculate. You have to go for first calculation, first set, and follow set. And any variable goes to nullable. Then you have to say that variable is nullable. Then you have to take. Then you have to take first function of that variable nullable. Then you have to take follow of that function.
Follow of that function.
Of the variable. And first and follow should intersection should be shy. First of that variable and follow intersection should be shy. If a variable say A goes to alpha 1, A goes to alpha 2, A goes to alpha 3, there are the strings, then first of alpha 1, first of alpha 2, first of alpha 3, intersection should be shy. Okay, then if it is okay, so left hand side all variables you have to take first and follow, and if a variable goes to multiple string, A goes to alpha 1, A goes to alpha 2, then you have to take first alpha 1, first alpha 2, first alpha 3, then all first of all A for variable A, first of alpha, first of alpha 2 intersection should be shy. And if variable A goes to nullable, that any variable which goes to nullable, you have to take first of that variable and follow up that variable should be shy, intersection should be shy. Then it can be guaranteed it is a LL1, and then you have to go for LL1 table. Then LL1 table, left hand side should be all variables, top should be your terminals. And everywhere you have to practice it. Then everyone I will cover in the class, and only one and only one rule can come into this. And this, whenever you are the precondition, necessary and sufficient condition, I have told you. Then if you find it is okay, then you go for LL1. And LL1 table, whenever it is there, then it is a guaranteed, unambiguous, it is guaranteed, it can be done ON, it can be recursive descent without backtracking. So what is the difference between recursive descent and LL1? You can tell that LL1 parsing is nothing but recursive descent without backtracking. Recursive descent can have backtracking, and recursive LL1 is recursive descent. Another name is recursive descent without backtracking.
Without backtracking.
Thank you very much. I am recording.